drive. They're in for a tough test here, though. Third and long.
Right there, 54.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. Derrick Brown able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Like the footwork back there, and I thought he did a pretty good job of evading that first wave of players. Tried to buy a little extra time out of the pocket, but in the end, oh, that was a tough one.
Yeah, winds up getting buried for the loss. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. Hopkins' kick is good. And they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10.
Panther is 10.
So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Carolina offense about ready to go. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. Bridgewater and the Panthers going to come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
8 yards on the pickup.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. And the Washington pressure gets to him. He will go down.
Teddy Bridgewater's sack.
Someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
And 13.
Third and long now after the sack. And we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. From the gun, Bridgewater. Open man is Samuel, complete. And this won't be enough. A good secure tackle, and they stop him a few yards shy at the 46. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. They'll run for it. McCaffrey, and he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Fourth and 2 in the NFL, not ordinarily a running down anymore.
Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Matt Ioannidis racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
To try again after the sack, Bridgewater over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
That'll be taken in by Anderson. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple of scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is.
20, Panthers 10.
Washington offense going back to work. And even with the missed field goal that we just saw, they still have to try and erase a two-score fourth-quarter deficit. And that one, just an absolute killer. A chance to get this back within one score.
All hope not gone yet, but at the same time, you're exactly right. They needed to get back within one score and have a motivated defense take the field in order to get it back for them for one last big drive.
This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up?
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll look to throw here. And he'll complete this to Gibson. And he is going to lose yardage here. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
Second and 11. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Trey Boston. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
By the Panthers.
Well, holding on to the lead at this stage in the second half, those are the types of plays you really want to try and stay away from.
And when you're a rookie, keeping your focus is something that you still have to work on all the time because there's so many distractions around you between the crowd noise and your coaches and your teammates. But the other part, you've got to learn how to finish. It's the two Fs for a rookie quarterback.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
A gain of a yard. Brings up
throwing, Bridgewater. Yeah, he's got it. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Robbie Anderson. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. So they get the score, partner. Game's not over, but they still need some help here.
Agreed. They definitely need some help, but they took care of the first part by scoring themselves.
Slide for the PAT.
The point after.
It's up and good, and the lead's now down to 3 at 20-17. They had the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
Washington takes over first and 10 at their own.
Now comes the Washington offense as we get a look at the playoff race in the NFC. Well, we do know, Charles, they will be in the playoffs. They currently sit at pole position number 1, but nothing set in stone right now. They still have to earn that top spot.
And it makes me reflect back to preseason when you and I do our tours of camps. The prevailing message in each and every one of them was what? Win the division.
Win the division.
Win the division. You know you're in the playoffs. It means something. It means a home game. It means a number of other things. But winning the division is paramount. You're right. They won't step off the gas here.
4 yards on the pickup.
Second. They'll keep it on the ground. Gibson, absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1?
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting. And even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Here's Tressway now as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. Uses the spin. So possession goes over here on the punt, and possession will switch hands. 1st and 10. Getting set to go here, Teddy Bridgewater and company marches back onto the field. Certainly they want to win this game, but down 3, they know what they need to do. Get in field goal range, at least have a chance to tie.
And if you approach it the right way, you almost have a safety net. Knowing just a field goal gets it done, you don't press for the touchdown. But you take it if the opportunity comes, if the opening's there. Someone slips in the secondary and you get a big play. But otherwise, get the 3, put that on the board, and try to extend the game.
They'll be trying to muster 3. Of course, they'd love the score to win it.
That could very well be a defining play in this game. A touchdown, that gives them a lead, and they took a major step towards getting there with that big play right there.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Bridgewater gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey.
Bridgewater's pass.
3 yards to the gain there, 2nd down.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Caught by the tight end, Ertz. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. This is 3rd and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They had the catch on 2nd down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at 3rd down here. To the air again with Bridgewater. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. And he is going to have a Panthers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Bridgewater to throw. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down. That's to McCaffrey, complete.
Bridgewater's pass.
And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. First things first here, they got to pick up the 1st down.
And remember, it is 4th down, so they've got to pick up a completion here. Otherwise, this one's over.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to potentially send us to overtime. And his kick is indeed good. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. So in the final minute, they turn it over to their kicker to get him back to even, and he does not disappoint.
Brandon, do you think the pressure ever gets to this guy? Because I sure don't. That was pretty smooth right there. But I tell you, he better not rest on his laurels, because there's a good chance they may need him again if this game goes to overtime.
1st and 10. at their own 26-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They, of course, tie game, would like to avoid overtime if they could.
And a lot of people would go ahead and play it safe here and get to overtime and try and win it there. But, you know, sitting up here in the booth,
take some gambles.
I say let's go for this thing, try and push it, and maybe catch the defense back on their heels a bit.
See if they do that. Second and six. Looking long for Thomas. And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime, obviously a touchdown to win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now the first throw in overtime for Bridgewater. And he's got it complete to Anderson. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run.
And how about that? So many times the big play is what does it in overtime. They got one there, move the ball past midfield, and now you know they're on the move, looking to score the game-winning touchdown because a field goal won't finish the game.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's Bridgewater. Escaping the pressure right. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
We saw it at Stanford. It does not surprise me to see it here in the NFL as well. This is one elusive young man.
He set the NCAA record in 2015, 3,864 all-purpose yards.
Listen, after watching that move, I just called for the trainer. I think I pulled a hammy just watching him.
They'll try to run with McCaffrey. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
Now from the 9, here's second and goal. They'll try to throw here now, Bridgewater. And that's going to be incomplete. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal.
It's third down and
Bridgewater now. The quick slant caught. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina.
Curtis Samuel. Touchdown, Carolina.
See and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later. Hey,
you really just wanted four quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So for Carolina, it's an important win for their playoff hopes as they hit the 10-win mark now at 10-5. And they'll return home next week to take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for Washington, this was basically just an exhibition game for them as they'd already clinched home field advantage. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Philly to face off with the Eagles. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
With the swag, bet you can't do it like me. All my winners on repeat. Take your L like a boss, standing toes on your feet. I can never take a loss, I ain't set up for defeat. Four Giottos on the truck, I had a dream and it stuck. Living my life cause we up, looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key, but contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets, struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash, but baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately I've been scheming against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, but how you gon' act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
You can fold or you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, out the